pretty much all the problems you can solve in any programming language, you name it. Many people might think that I have gone mad because I am saying I love C++. I am still in love with C++. Even after writing production level code in 5 programming languages and learning a couple of more languages out of interest, I can say with confidence that I still love C++. So before I get into nitty-gritty details of it, let me tell you a very small story. And with this story, you will understand how the things are advertised against other thing. I always felt that if you want to, you know, make your line bigger, draw a bigger line, you don't need to erase other line to make your line looks bigger. Why I am telling this? Let me tell you a very simple story. And here is how the story goes. Sometime back in an office, not so far away, there was a meeting that was scheduled by, you know, programmers, product managers, stakeholders to decide which programming language they will use for their upcoming work. One engineer said that let's use C++, it's fast and it can help us to do things whatever we want to do in the best possible way. We have experienced people in C++. Another engineer said that, you know, no, let's not use C++. It is not having garbage collector in it. We will have lots of memory leaks and code dumps. Many other engineers, you know, seconded that thought, and that thought looks very nice. That thought looks like, you know, this is the problem we must avoid, and this is the problem that comes only and only with C++. So people decided to go ahead with a language with built-in garbage collector. So far, so good, but the story doesn't end here. 6 months down the line, people were discussing about the problem that they were experiencing in their current code. They were experiencing some memory leaks that is happening despite using the garbage collector language. Over a period of time, the memory was keep on increasing and it was not releasing back. People were struggling to find the appropriate GC option, garbage collector options, and they were coming up with thoughts like, let's make the variable explicitly null so that garbage collector can pick it up. The story ends here, but the crux of this story is that if you outsource, it doesn't mean that you can just get away with it. You can forget about it. Outsourcing the memory management to garbage collector doesn't mean that you should never ever think about it. There are memory leaks in all the products created in all the possible programming languages with garbage collector or without. Now, why I told you this story? I told you this story because when the garbage collector languages came into picture, the primary intention was to, you know, garbage collector, you don't need to worry about memory allocation, deallocation, etc. Somehow, in my 22 years of experience, I was never sold, never purchased, and never admired the only criteria for moving from C++ to another language is garbage collector. Code dumps may be a valid reason, but code dumps comes because of, you know, programmer's mistake. And to an extent, I agree that some languages help you to avoid that, and that's a great feature. Now, before I go ahead, let me clarify that I'm not saying anything against any programming language with garbage collector or without, or, you know, with scripting or without scripting, compiled language, or for that matter, any other differentiation you can think of. The programmers who are comfortable with one language, they would like to go ahead and work in that particular language. Okay, and there is nothing wrong in that. Pretty much all the problems you can solve in any programming language, you name it. There may be some difference between speed, execution, libraries, availability, ease of doing things, but pretty much all the problems you can solve in all programming languages. So if someone is selecting a programming language, that's their choice. There is nothing good or bad with it. Now, coming back to C++ again, why I am still in love with C++? I love C++ because the kind of fearless programmer I am today, it's only and only because of my working, my experiences with C++ programming language. It's because of that language I am not at all fearful of any language for that matter. I am capable of coding, learning any programming language you throw at me. Because when I programmed for many years in C++, I had to take care of each and everything. from, of course, memory to code dumps to compiler option to optimization options, and how the thread will look like, how multiprocessing would look like, and how to make sure that threads are distributed properly. All those things you have to take care of, and that made me a better programmer. And believe me, even today when I'm working in many other programming languages, I am confident only and only because I worked in C++ for a very long time. That made me such a good programmer, and I'm not exaggerating myself, and I'm not, you know, praising myself. But I felt that, you know, while interacting with other people also, that I'm a decent programmer, you know, if not the ultra best one can get. And most often than not, if there is something that is not working, no matter which programming language you use, things are not working because of, you know, some mistakes done by programmers, some things ignored by programmers. When programmers use some kind of high-level language, they think that this is something I don't need to worry about. That's a wrong thought process, and that is creating dumb software programmers. Being a creator of any software, whatever programming language you are coding, you have to take care of everything. If there is a garbage collector, you need to write your code in such a way where garbage collector can use all those things in an efficient and effective way. Garbage collector is not an artificially intelligent entity. The same garbage collector, one person can write super fast code, another person can write, you know, worst possible code. And the second reason why I love C++ still is that it had changed a lot. And in that sense, C++ 11 was game changer, and the functionalities that is being added with 14, C++ 17, 20 and upcoming 23 versions, it had changed the language drastically without taking away all the flexibilities of a programmer, all the creative thinking a programmer can come up with while coding in C++. And believe me, there is a reason why Google has decided to come up with something called Carbon. It's an experimental language touted to be as, you know, extension of C++ or replacement of C++ in near future. But there was something in C++, and that's why, despite having its own language called Go, Google is trying to come up with Carbon. So Carbon has launched recently. I haven't experienced it yet, but I'm going to look into that in some time to come, and I'll tell you how it looks like. But believe me, if you want to become a better programmer, if you want to understand things, and if you want to understand things which can help you to write better code in any other programming language, I do believe that C and C++ is something you should give it a try. Even today, we are approaching towards end of 2022, but even today it matters. We need better programmers. We need thoughtful programmers. We need programmers who, while writing the code, can, you know, make a map in their mind that what is happening where, so that they can write a better code, they can write a better software, they can create a better product. And those are the reasons why I am still in love with C++, and I am still coding in C++ programming language. So that was my take on it. Thank you all. Thanks for watching. We will meet again. Until the next time we meet, good day, goodbye. You take care.